What's up guys, Blitz here today bringing you another video. Aerith's Advanced Guide is here, and in this video we're going to be breaking down two builds for her. Aerith is Final Fantasy VII Remake's Black and White Mage. She has the highest magic attack in the game and can be built in different ways. We can have her as full on support with heals or do crazy black mage damage with spells. Her kit is unique as she can buff and apply so much utility to the group no matter what role she's in. Each and every character in this game is really good to use, and it just comes down to preference as to who you play as at the end of the day. I admit she's my least played character in the game, but that's just because I prefer to have a different setup for my characters. But with Aerith in your party, your entire team's damage and endurance is massively buffed. Be sure to leave a like on this video and subscribe if you're new. Leave a comment below which video you'd like to see next, since we are all done with all the advanced character guides. Finally. Expect more weapon builds and boss guides, but also let me know other things you may be interested in watching. And without further ado, let's get into Aerith's Advanced Guide. Aerith's basic attacks are magic-based and can do crazy damage compared to original Final Fantasy VII. Tapping square 5 times can do the entire string, which hits 5 times and spreads out across all enemies. Instead of tapping, you can actually hold down square and she'll do the entire attack string. This way is much better. At any time during her square basic attacks, Aerith can actually hit circle to dodge out of the way of incoming attacks. She doesn't have the greatest mobility or defense, so you want to block most attacks. Aerith's triangle ability is called Tempest, and it has two functions. If you tap triangle, you get a long windup and Aerith launches 3 weaker hitting basic attack orbs. They do less damage, but they add more stagger and fill up more ATB. You can actually hold triangle to charge up Tempest, and once it's fully charged, Aerith will launch it at the enemy. This creates a diamond that if enemies stand inside of it for a long time, it can burst and launches multiple high damaging projectiles at whoever was standing inside. This can hit multiple enemies, but it's very easy to dodge. It's best to use on an enemy that does not move that often or after you just staggered someone. This will ensure a higher chance of landing this. Compared to the damage Aerith can put out with her spells, Tempest is not something you'll be using that often. Trust me, you'll understand when we get to our builds. Aerith's basic attacks can actually hit long range enemies and spread out against multiple targets. The more enemies that are hit, the higher your ATB generation will be. So Aerith will very often have lots of ATB to use, so be sure to always switch to her to use an attack. The first weapon Aerith gets is called the Guard Stick. This is an all around general weapon that offers great stat increases to almost everything. The ability that comes with this is the Arcane Ward. This is the bread and butter of the character Aerith. Arcane Ward places an AoE pool that if any teammate stands inside and casts an attack spell, it gets casted twice for discounted MP and less damage. The whole entire team can use this, so if you're running lots of attack spells, you need to be using this move with Aerith in almost every encounter. Arcane Ward can be absolutely broken, especially with the right build and magic attacks. Even if an enemy is not weak against your selected magic attack, you can expect crazy damage to be inflicted. And if they are weak to that attack, then expect the encounter to end extremely quickly. Aerith's default ability, already known by her, is called Soul Drain. This move is an attack which can interrupt certain enemies casting spells. But the secondary effect allows the ability to drain and give Aerith some MP from that enemy. The damage you get from this is solid overall, and the MP regain is absolutely valuable, especially on a hard mode playthrough. Normally this move can regain a decent amount of MP, about 5 or 7 depending on the enemy. But if the enemy is staggered, you can now recover a crazy amount of MP at over 20. Very valuable move for Aerith, especially on hard mode. If you're struggling for MP in hard mode, get those enemies staggered and use this move as much as possible. Guardstick's cores for skills are well balanced like everyone else's first weapon. The first core offers everything from magic attack power, defense, HP, and MP. The second core increases Aerith's basic attack's damage and Tempest by 5%. You could also buff your defense by 10% when blocking physical or magical attacks. In core 3, we get MP regeneration stat of 10%, which is decent because in other weapons we have better options. Core 4 allows us to save 20% MP when using healing spells, which is super valuable in a support build and hard mode. The final core gives us reprieve, where we can survive a killing blow one time per encounter. Overall, very good stuff inside of this weapon, but nothing too groundbreaking. This next weapon, the Silver Staff, is the best weapon in the game for Aerith. The ability Sorcerer's Storm is great for getting enemies off of you and doing magic-based AoE damage. Aerith oftentimes is using her attacks and generates a lot of aggro and can be mobbed easily. Use this move to get enemies off you quickly, as it can hit everything around you regardless of how many enemies are around. This move can also pressure enemies quickly, so once you see that happens, be sure to run away and regain space for range attacks against enemies. Overall, this weapon does not have the highest damage output, but that's not what makes it the best. This weapon can give you some game-changing skill bonuses in these cores. The first core is nothing fancy, just generic bonuses, but the second core can buff your spell damage depending on which element you're using. The third core, we get crazy MP regeneration boost of 50%. This is insane for hard mode especially, as you will now be gaining back MP, which is tough to do in that mode. Also at full MP, you get a damage boost by 20%. The fourth core is where this weapon gets crazy. You can get both 20% MP reduction on attack spells and healing spells, making this weapon the ultimate one for Aerith, since now she can restore so much valuable MP while also saving on attack and healing spells. Trade-off also helps you regain MP too, so this weapon goes all out when it comes to conservation. The last core also offers reprieve, which will save you from dying one time per encounter and is super clutch. The next weapon, Arcane Scepter, offers more material slots early on, but no real reason to use this during the endgame. The ability that comes with this is Fleeting Familiar. This move summons a fairy that hangs around Aerith dealing basic attack damage. This can also deal more attacks and damage when you use other abilities and spells. This is just extra damage on top of what you're currently dealing with as Aerith. The fairy doesn't do crazy damage, so it's not entirely useful against bosses. But if you're standing in an arcane ward and you use an ability, the fairy will launch two orange orbs dealing bonus damage and stagger bar increases as well to the enemies. Arcane Scepter's first core can increase your debuffs and buff duration by 10%. The second core, like Silver Staff, offers damage increases to spells or to your elemental materia pairing. The third core can give a stagger siphon to self-heal when staggering enemies and bonuses to attack damage by 5%. Attack spells MP reduction by 20% is actually a really great skill on top of the 10% MP regeneration. But Silver Staff offers this plus much more and attack damage on top of that. The final core can boost our defense against elemental damage by 5% and gives us reprieve again. The Mithril Rod is the strongest weapon for Aerith. For pure damage Black Mage builds, this is the weapon to go for. The ability that comes with this is called the Ray of Judgment. This move costs 2 ATB bars and has a bit of startup, but the damage and animation from it are amazing. This move's main use is for when an enemy is staggered. You want to use this to increase their stagger percentages alongside Tifa. Both Aerith and Tifa can get enemies above 300% together easily. By itself, this move can get enemies from 160% to 180%. Compared to Tifa, this is not amazing considering she can get over 70% in 3 hits, but when both of these characters are together and an enemy is staggered, be sure to use this and then switch to Tifa to then apply all that crazy stagger percentage increase to really put the hurting on enemies. The Mithril Rod is super focused on magic attack damage and just making Aerith hurt enemy. The first core increases damage and MP total. The second core can give us Bloodsucker, which heals you slightly when killing an enemy, and you could also get 20% magic damage boost when you're at full MP. The third core is just more damage and slight defense increases when at high HP. The final core just increases our damage further and offers more resistance to debuffs. Just raw, crazy damage from this weapon. The Bladed Staff is an interesting option for Aerith. This gives us more higher physical attack damage than she normally gets, as well as plenty of skills relating to critical hit damage. The ability for this weapon is the Lustra Shield. This creates a magical shield which slightly damages enemies that are nearby it, and negates almost all incoming projectiles. You can create up to 2 shields on the battlefield at one time. This move is best for defending you while you're on your arcane ward. It's also really good for boss fights when you know a really tough projectile is incoming. The Bladed Staff is probably the most unique weapon for Aerith. The first core offers luck increase by 5, which boosts your critical hit rate and damage. Core number 2 can increase your crit hit rate, damage increase, and crippling damage by 10%, as well as a 50% increase when you're at low HP. The third core has nothing too crazy, to be honest, but the fourth core helps our defense when at low HP and increases crit rate damage by 10% again. The final core gives us a magic power increase when at high HP and stagger siphon to regain health when attacking a staggered enemy. Physical attack stats give Aerith more damage when at close range, so if you're going for a crit damage and close range combat, then this unorthodox weapon is meant for you. The final weapon, the Reinforced Staff, gives Aerith the highest blend of physical attack damage, magical attack damage, and slightly more magical defense. This weapon ability is ATB Ward, which is very similar to Arcane Ward and gives us an AoE pool. This costs 2 ATB bars, but when you use it, it gives Aerith back 1 ATB, so then you can attach this with Arcane Ward if needed. When teammates use ATB within this pool, they regain half ATB back from Aerith's gauge, so it trades from Aerith to the teammate in the pool. This has its uses, especially if you're generating and pulling in crazy ATB with Aerith. You can basically feed your teammates non-stop ATB this way and keep attacks going. The Reinforced Staff is not a terrible weapon to use. The first core offers buff duration and debuff resistance. The second core increases our blocking defense for physical and magical attacks, as well as a self-healing boost of 50% when at low HP. Core number 3 increases our Tempest damage and offers magic defensive increases, while the final core gives us a lot of HP and offers reprieve. The first build we're going to showcase is an all-out damage Black Mage build. This build focuses heavily on damage but can support teammates as well. The weapon of choice is the Mithril Rod for the most magical attack damage. However, you can switch this to the Silver Staff and then add 2 magic up materials to have amazing damage and sweet MP saving abilities. Chain Bangle gives us 50-50 defense for magical and physical, but also gives us 4 materia slots. you usually run the chain bank on either Aerith or Barret. The accessory of choice is the Platinum Earrings because this increases Aerith's magic attack power by 10%. I prefer this on Aerith rather than the circlet because we're going for raw damage output. The circlet increases MP, but not by that much. When it comes to the materia, the most popular option for any build is Magnify. This materia is basically the all materia from Final Fantasy VII Original, and when paired with a healing materia, it can heal all teammates, or if using an attack spell, it can attack all enemies. The trade-off is when it's finally maxed out, you lose 25% of potency, but that's okay since Aerith has crazy damage overall. We're using fire here to basically nuke enemies, but adjust this to benefit the enemy's weaknesses depending on who you're facing. The next materia is Prayer. This is entirely optional, but I like to have some sort of healing materia on Aerith. And Prayer affects the entire party and does not cost any MP, so we can save all of that MP for dealing damage. First Strike is almost a must-have on Aerith since we need to get things going with her immediately as the match starts. We want to be able to cast Arcane Ward immediately and then start sending out attacks. We're a bit greedy here, so we have Magic Up materia to boost our damage even more in this build. We also have MP up, but that may not be needed when using the Silver Staff, but it's good to have this extra MP just in case we're running low on MP issues. Subversion materia I feel is a must on Aerith because most enemies when they take enough magical damage will cast Reflect and negate all incoming magic attack damage, basically making Aerith useless. So we can use Breach to get rid of this shield on them and bring back on the pain with Aerith. Aerith has the lowest health in the game, so an HP up is almost necessary to keep on her. And finally, another MP up to keep our magic spells flowing non-stop. This way we can tack on the most possible damage. The summon materia of choice is the Leviathan materia for the magic stat bonuses all across the board. When running this build, it's almost vital that you have the cleanse materia on a party member. Many enemies will silence you when you start casting plenty of spells, and that's gonna happen more than you think with this build. If I can be totally honest with you guys, Aerith is more efficient when not using battle shortcuts. With Aerith, you need to take your time and slowly analyze what's going on with nearby enemies. So by using the command menu, that's your best bet when using her. But my personal shortcuts, if I use any, are these. Soul Drain is on Square because I can interrupt certain incoming spell attacks on enemies, very quickly too since I'm attacking with Square. And also, it's really great to use on hard mode to increase your MP regeneration, while also using on staggered enemies to recover max MP. On Triangle, I have Arcane Ward, which is my most used shortcut for Aerith, especially when starting counters. You can immediately cast this thanks to First Strike as soon as the match starts and place it wherever you need to be. And, like all my other AoE spells, I keep Sorcerer's Storm on Circle to activate when Aerith is being bum-rushed by enemies, which happens very often, so keep this on standby. And finally, Ray of Judgment is on her X, so I can increase the stagger percentage when needed to be done quickly. As for her Limit Break, Healing Wind is sort of a lackluster party-wide heal in my opinion, but her second Limit Break, Planet's Protection, is absolutely amazing. It negates all physical attacks coming into your party members, which is super great for those clutch and crazy moments when you need to recuperate and heal yourself. This Black Mage build may just be for damage, but you could also provide support and help buff your teammates as well. Arcane Ward is a huge part to the character Aerith, and you need to be utilizing this in almost every encounter, as it not only helps her, but it helps the entire party. And once you have everybody's ATBs built up, you can take them over to the Arcane Ward and begin setting up your spells in the queue. This can be overkill for many enemies, but at the same time against bosses, it can put them in pressured states or stagger them really quickly. There are many other crazy builds you can create where Aerith can actually pair a spell materia with Magnify, and pair that second materia of the same spell with an MP or HP absorb. This way you can return back some health or MP using these attacks. If that's more up your alley, be sure to check that out because there's plenty of combinations you can do like that in Final Fantasy VII Remake. Not everyone's build will be the same, so I'm encouraging you guys to share your builds in the comments below. I love hearing what you guys got to offer for these characters and maybe even helping me change up mine as well. Many times, enemies will silence or cast Reflect to protect themselves against Aerith. So be sure that another teammate has Cleanse on to clear Silence and also make sure Aerith has Subversion materia to remove Reflects or Barriers. Against some enemies too, when you remove that barrier, they will go into a pressured state and can be staggered really easily now. Aerith is the clear-cut winner when you're focusing on magic and spell damage. If you have her in your party, you can only expect to bring on the damage even more so with teammates as well. It's great to see that she can not only be played in a regular support role, but also inflict or add on to more damage for the team. Capitalize on your opponent's weaknesses and be sure to keep applying pressure whenever you can. The command menu and slowing down time to analyze your surroundings are key for when playing Aerith. You'll get a lot more out of her this way and avoid unnecessary damage sometimes when you see what's coming your way. Every character can be built in different ways to focus on certain areas. That's one of my favorite things about this game, so I really do hope we get a co-op VR mode added so that we can play with friends, or even more so a hard mode for like bosses to challenge ourselves further. There's so many options for endgame content in this game that we can only hope and wish that Square Enix gets our attention. Aerith's damage is no joke. I truly think she is the key for the Pride and Joy boss fights, which I have an upcoming video for you guys about that, so stay tuned, because this build can make that entire mission easy mode. You almost feel bad for the bosses. Aerith's support build is an easy one to put together. We're using the Silver Staff because the bonuses to MP regeneration and saving MP on spells are by far the best in the game. You just can't ignore these bonuses that you get from this weapon. Chain Bangle for 4 materia slots and balanced defense, and Platinum Earrings to keep our magic power at a nice level. With the materia, we have the Magnify materia again, but this time it's paired with healing for crazy big party-wide heals. Even with a 25% hit to potency, Aerith can still fully heal the entire party from 1 to max. It's pretty crazy. This can actually be swapped out with Barrier if you choose to increase everyone's defense instead. Revival materia is a must in this game's hard mode since items are disabled and enemies will hit you much harder. Any attack spell materia is also great to have due to her saving 20% on those, so don't shy away from using any of that. Prayer materia is kind of a last resort kind of materia to help if we run out of MP or to help us conserve more MP. Feel free to swap this out with anything else if you prefer. First Strike is needed to get our support goals rolling early on. We have 2 magic ups to have our damage equal to what it was in the Black Mage build. Mine aren't maxed out here, but if they were, we'd have much higher damage overall, so be aware of that. HP up Aerith needs due to her low vitality, and MP up to have us at a solid 150 MP total for casting spells. And finally, our summon materia is Leviathan to give us magic stats all across the board. Aerith's support build revolves around you not controlling her all the time. You gotta alternate between Cloud or whoever else to keep enemies off of her. Once your teammates are really low health, you can definitely count on Kiraga with Magnify to get them right back up to full HP. Outside of arcane wards and other shields you can apply to the battlefield, you want to continuously switch on and off of her. She literally carries the party as far as their life bars can go. With all the MP that you save and can regain from Silver Staff in this build, it's not a problem to spam Kiragas whenever needed. But also, don't forget to throw out your attack spells whenever possible, because those are discounted and can cause pressure or stagger enemies really quickly. As I said, this is more of a regular role and can be kind of boring in most cases, but she still can pour on damage just as well as Mithril Rod. So if you want, be sure to throw on another attack spell and remove Prayer. Or even better, remove Prayer and combine your attack spell with MP Absorb. This way you can regain and save MP a lot quicker when dealing damage. This build really can be changed in so many different ways. Ultimately, I think this is the best way to play Aerith because it's crazy versatile and good for hard mode or against any bosses. That also depends on whether or not you as a player are constantly managing and changing which spells you have depending on what the enemies are weak to. Aerith at first may seem a bit complicated, but she really isn't that difficult to figure out and learn to use. Whether it's for damage or to support, she has no trouble with either and excels very well at both. Make sure to queue up those attack spells to pressure enemies, then Ray of Judgment them when they are staggered. Keep your teammates' health topped off, and always have an arcane ward up. Those are the simple keys to using Aerith in Final Fantasy VII Remake. And that wraps it up for the How to Use Aerith Advanced Combat Guide, guys. Let me know in the comments below what you guys thought. Also, write down what builds you guys like to run with Aerith. Pretty simple and straightforward, guys. She truly brings on the damage against any enemy. She works extremely well in any team composition too, so be sure to figure out your best combinations. And don't shy away from using Aerith. I'm happy these Advanced Combat series are finally over so we can get into more fun and interesting videos for you guys. From all of which you guys have been recommending me, I'm super thankful and I'm definitely going to be trying them all out. So we will be taking all of that into consideration. Materia combinations, boss guides, full team build compositions are definitely coming your way and you won't want to miss that. I think I've figured out how to fix my Let's Play series audio, so hopefully we can get those up on the channel for you guys again soon. I'm still looking forward to streaming to you all as well. I'm sorry, but some real life stuff was getting in the way and I needed to take care of that first, so I will be dedicating a day to work on that so we can get some things running up ASAP. Out of all 4 of these characters, who have been your most fun to play as? For me, it's been Melee Barret recently. That weapon is just too much fun and absolutely destroys enemies. Be sure to like the video if you enjoyed and subscribe if you're new. More Final Fantasy VII Remake videos will be coming your way and you won't want to miss that. My name is Blitz and thanks for watching.